Hello dear students, welcome back to online English classes. In the previous session, we have started with one of the important grammar topics, that is subject-verb agreement. Let's have a small recap of what we have learnt in the previous session. In the previous session, we have studied the basic subject-verb agreement rule, that is a singular subject takes singular form of the verb with S or ES at the end. A plural subject takes plural form of the verb with no S or ES at the end. And we have also understood that this basic subject verb agreement only applies in the present tense. And we have also learned how to change nouns into pronouns. And we have seen a few singular and plural pronouns as subjects. And we have also seen how the verb forms change according to the subject. And we have also seen how the verb be, that is am, is, are, was and were, works in a sentence. Well, there are several subject verb agreement rules. Let us learn and understand a few important subject verb agreement rules in this session. Now the rule is, if there are two singular nouns or pronouns joined by and, the verb must be plural. Take for example, Suraj and Ravi are friends. Here in the sentence, Suraj is a singular subject and Ravi is also a singular subject. So according to the rule, the verb must be plural. So the verb used here is are. So here in this sentence, Suraj is a singular subject. Similarly, Ravi is also a singular subject. But these two singular nouns are joined by and. So the verb must be plural in form. So the verb used here is plural are. Similarly, in the second sentence, Ramesh and Abhishek were absent in the class yesterday. Here you can see two singular nouns, that is Ramesh and Abhishek. Ramesh is a singular subject. Similarly, Abhishek is also a singular subject, but these two singular subjects are connected by and. So the verb must be plural in form. So the verb used here is plural verb were. And in the next sentence, gold and silver are precious metals. Here also you can see gold is a singular subject and similarly silver is also another singular subject, but these two singular nouns or subjects are connected by and. So the verb used here is plural are, not is. As I already told you, if there are two singular nouns or pronouns joined by and, the verb must be plural. So here you can see two singular pronouns, he and I. Here you can see the pronouns he and I connected by and. In that case also, the verb must be plural in form. So the verb used here is plural verb were. But there is an exception to this rule. So the exception is, if there are two singular nouns or pronouns joined by an but used as a single unit, or if the nouns in a sentence suggest one idea to the mind, or it refers to the same person or thing in a sentence, in that case the verb must be singular. Take for example, in the first sentence, slow and steady wins the race. Here, slow and steady is an idiomatic expression which means consistency in progress may be slow but eventually be more beneficial rather than being hasty or careless for getting things done in life. So the words slow and steady also means carefully with full attention, focusing on doing each detailed step properly in full control. This idiomatic expression slow and steady basically describes the quality of one person, third person singular number. So these two words, slow and steady, do not refer to different things here, but it is used as a single unit. So the verb must be singular in form. So the verb used here is wins. Here the rule of adding s to the verb sustains. Remember the basic subject verb agreement rule, what it says: a singular subject takes a singular form of the verb with s or es at the end. So here we see slow and steady as a single unit. We consider it as a singular subject, so the verb needs to be singular in form, and we add s to the verb and make it singular. So the verb used here is singular, wins. Similarly, in the second sentence, the two nouns bread and butter used as a single unit. It talks about the same thing here. So the verb used here is singular, is, not are. And in the next sentence, the novelist and poet is dead. So here in the sentence, the person who is died is both the novelist and a poet. So here in the sentence, the two nouns, the novelist and poet, refer to one person, and here it considered as one single unit. So the verb needs to be singular in form. So the verb used here is singular, is, not are. And in the next sentence, honor and glory is his reward. So here in the sentence, the two nouns honor and glory used to show respect for someone's notable achievements. It's an expression which used to show respect for someone's achievement in life. So here the two nouns honor and glory used as a single unit. In that case, the verb needs to be singular in form. So the verb used here is, not are. Let us move on to the next rule. So here the rule is, if there are two nouns joined by any of these words or any of these expressions, they are no less than, as well as, with, along with, together with. In that case, the form of the verb should be used according to the first noun. Take for example, I no less than you, I am to be blamed. It is because the two nouns I and you are joined by no less than. So the form of the verb should be placed according to the first noun. So here the first noun is I, it is singular. So we use the singular verb am. Here the pronoun I always have the verb am. In the present tense, the pronoun I will always have the verb am. In the next sentence, Ashok as well as Anil lives in Mysore. Here also you can see the two singular nouns, Ashok and Anil, are connected by or joined by as well as. In that case, the verb must be singular. So we use singular noun here, leaves, not leave. Here the expression as well as is an adverb. It also means in addition to and also. So here in the sentence, the second noun Anil is used in addition to the first noun Ashok. So in that case, the subject is considered as singular. So we use the singular verb here, leaves, not leave. Similarly, in the next sentence, the house with its furniture was burnt. Here the two different nouns, the house and furniture, is joined by with. So in that case, the verb must be singular in form. So we use the singular verb was here. And in the last example, the ship with its crew was lost. So here also you can see the two different singular nouns, the ship and crew. But these two singular nouns joined by with. So according to the rule, we should use the singular verb. So the verb used here is was, not were. Let us move on to the next rule. So here the rule is, if there are two singular nouns or pronouns preceded by any of these words or expressions, they are not only follows but also, neither follows nor, and either follows or. So the verb must agree with the subject near to it. So let us see a few examples here. In the first sentence, not only we but also our parents want us to win. Here you can see two nouns. They are we and parents are preceded by not only but also. So here the verb must agree with the subject near to it. So let us find out which is the subject near to it. So here you can see we have used plural verb want. This verb is nearer to the subject parent. So this plural verb want is nearer to the plural subject parents. So the verb must be agree with the subject near to it. So here is the verb, and this plural verb is nearer to the plural subject parents. Well, in the next sentence, neither the students nor the teacher is going for excursion. So here in the sentence you can see two nouns. They are the students and the teacher. So according to the rule, the verb agrees with the subject near to it. So here the verb we used. So here the verb used singular in form is, because the subject near to it is a singular subject. So the verb used here is singular is. Well, in the next sentence, neither the speaker nor the audience were present. So here in the sentence you can see two nouns. They are the speaker and the audience. So according to the rule, the verb must agree with the subject near to it. So let us find out which is the subject near to the verb here. So here we use plural verb were, because the subject near to it is the plural subject, the audience. So the audience is a plural subject. So we use the plural verb were. Here one thing you should notice, though the word audience seems like a singular word, but it is plural in meaning. So the verb used here is plural were, not was. Similarly, in the next sentence, either captain or players are asked to speak. So here also you can see two nouns, captain and players. So according to the rule, the verb must agree with the subject near to it. So here the noun players is nearer to the verb are. Since the subject players is plural, so we use the plural verb are, not is. So here in the next example, you can see two nouns, captain and players, are preceded by either and or. And according to the rule, the verb must agree with the subject near to it. And since the subject near the verb is plural, we use the plural verb are, not is. Here in the last example, you can see two nouns, my friend and I, preceded by neither and nor. So here, according to the rule, The verb must agree with its subject near to it. So here, since the pronoun I is singular, we use singular verb I am, which is near to it. Let us move on to the next rule. So here the rule is, if two or more singular subjects connected by or nor requires a singular verb. Let us see a few examples. In the first sentence, no nook or corner was left unexplored. Here the words no nook or corner means to search in every place or every corner. So here the two words no nook and corner are connected by or. So according to the rule, it requires a singular verb. So the verb used here is singular, was, not, were. In the next example, our happiness or our sorrow is largely due to our action. Here the two abstract nouns, happiness and sorrow, are connected by or. So according to the rule, it requires a singular verb, and the verb used here is singular, is. And we say, our happiness or our sorrow is largely due to our own actions. In the next example, neither food nor water was to be found there. Here also you can see two nouns. They are food and water. According to the rule, the verb must be singular in form. So we have used singular verb was, not were. And similarly, in the next example, neither praise nor blame seems to affect him. So here also you can see the words praise and blame are connected by nor. So according to the rule, so what the rule says, if two or more singular subjects connected by or nor requires a singular verb, so here the two subjects praise and blame are connected by nor. So the verb must be singular. So the rule of adding s to the verb applies here. So we have used the singular verb seems, but there is an exception to this rule. So the exception is, if one of the subjects in a sentence joined by or nor is plural, then the verb should be plural and it placed near to the plural subject. So the exception is, when one of the subjects joined by or nor in a sentence is plural, then we use plural verb form and the verb must be placed nearer to the plural subject. So these two are the exceptions. In this sentence, neither the chairman nor the directors are present. So here, as I already told you, if one of the subjects is plural connected by or nor in a sentence, then we use a plural verb are. And here we have used the plural verb are because the subject near to it is plural. Because the subject nearer to it is plural, the directors. And similarly, in the next sentence, neither the captain nor the players have played well. So here, since the subject near the verb is plural, so we have used the plural verb have, not has. So the verb have placed near the plural subject, the players. There is one more exception to this rule. So what it says, when the subjects joined by or nor are of different persons, then the verb must agree with the nearer one. So let us look into examples. Either he or I am mistaken. So here the pronouns he and I talks about two different people. So according to the rule, so what it says, so the verb must agree with the subject nearer. So here we have used verb I am because the pronoun I is singular. And in the second sentence, neither you nor he is to be blamed. So again, here the words you and he talks about two different people, and these two words are connected by nor. So what the rule says, the verb must agree with the subject nearer to it. So the verb used here is singular is. It is because the subject nearer to it, he, is also singular. Let us move on to the next rule. So the rule says, error of proximity should be avoided in a sentence. Let us see a few examples to understand it. In the first sentence, the cost of new cars, I have given options here, is or are rising. So what would you think? Which verb is correct here? Here in the sentence, we are not talking about cars, but we are talking about the cost of cars. So the verb should be used singular since the cost is singular. Since the subject is singular, the cost, the verb should be used singular is, not are. So the correct verb used here is, not are. Similarly, in the second sentence, we are not talking about his clothes, but we are talking about the appearance. Since the subject appearance is singular, we should use the singular verb is, not are. So that is what we call error of proximity. But let us look into next example. Here in the sentence, his knowledge of Indian vernaculars is far beyond the common. So here in the sentence, we are not talking about Indian vernaculars, but we are talking about his knowledge. So since knowledge is singular, we use the singular verb is, not are. So this is what we call error of proximity. It should be avoided in a sentence. Let us move on to the next rule. So the rule is, each, every, either, neither, many, must be followed by a singular verb. So let us look into examples. In the sentence, each of the students is present. So here the word each refers to each and everything or each and every person in a group. So it is considered singular. So we use the singular verb is. In the second sentence, every man, woman, child was happy. So here we have used singular verb was because the word every refers to all individual members in a group. They are man, woman, child. So according to the rule, so what it says, each, every, either, neither, many, must be followed by a singular verb form. So here we have used the singular verb was. In the next sentence, either of the boys is allowed to go out. So here in the sentence, we have used singular verb is. It is because of the word either. In the last sentence, neither of the two men was very strong. So here also you can see we have used singular verb form was. It is because of the subject, the two men, preceded by the word neither. Let us move on to the next rule. So what it says, some nouns are plural in form but singular in meaning. In that case, the verb must be singular. For example, the news is true. We don't say the news are true. Since the subject news is considered as singular, we use the singular verb form is. Economics is an interesting subject. The wages of sin is death. Acoustics is the study of sounds. So you can see in all these sentences, we have used singular form of the verb is. It is because all the nouns are plural in form but singular in meaning. Let us move on to the next rule. The rule is, when the plural nouns denote some specific quantity or amount, considered as a whole, the verb should be used singular. For example, 15 minutes is allotted to each speaker. Here we have used the singular verb is. It is because the subject 15 minutes is considered as a whole. It denotes a particular quantity or amount. In the next example, 15,000 rupees is a large amount. Here also you can see we have used singular verb form is. It is because the subject 15,000 rupees is considered as singular subject. This rule is just opposite to the previous rule. So we can say the nouns are singular in form but plural in meaning. Let us move on to the next rule. That is, a collective noun takes a singular verb when the collection is thought of as one whole. For example, the committee has issued its report. Here the collective noun, the committee, is considered as singular subject. So the verb must be singular in form. So we have used the singular verb has, not have. In the next sentence, the family is on US trip. So here also we can see we have used the singular verb form is. It is because the collective noun family is considered as singular subject. So we have used singular verb form is. And in the next sentence, the team begins practice today. Here also you can see we have used singular verb form begins. It is because the collective noun the team is considered as singular. But there is an exception to this rule. So the exception is a collective noun can also take plural verb when the individuals of it are thought of as a whole. For example, the committee are divided on one minor point. Here the verb are refers to each and every person in the committee. So in that case the verb should be plural in form. So we have used plural verb form are, not is. If you learn all these subject verb agreement rules and practice it every day, speaking and writing English with correct subject verb agreement is no problem at all. So I'll stop my session here. Thank you.